Welcome to another video of Biesse 24. This is a Rover Biesse 24, or it's a Biesse Rover 24. That's right. Anyway, I should know what equipment I'm working on. So what I'm going to talk about today is the entering of a program into the Biesse so that the Biesse will run it. This is quite a process on the Rover 24. So let's walk through it. After you've made your code with a program such as AlphaCam and you've used the appropriate post, and I can address that in a different video, you have to bring the program, the ANC program, over to the Biesse. So what I do is I use the internet OneDrive from Google, and I just plop it in there, and then I have this is the directory on my machine where I have to put the programs in order for them to be seen by the machine. It's actually this program file. And your machine will have a program file, but the machine won't see any of these programs unless they're in that file. So we are in Axis Designs, American Eagle, and then I'm right here. I'm gonna just go ahead and erase these. Let me just put them in the old cold file. So what I'm gonna do then is imagine this is where I want the code, and I'll get to that in a second. This is OneDrive. I've made the code. There's small programs, 49.4 kilobytes, 1.35 kilobytes, very small programs. So I'm going to download those to the Biesse computer, and then I'm going to take them and just drag them into that folder. All right, that's all well and good. You'd think, well, on other machines you just go ahead and run the program. Not on Biesse. It needs to set up parameters, and I think it does it in Spanish or Italian, I don't know, but anyway, beyond that, the way to do that is down here on your screen. There will probably be a list of programs. You'll want to go to Editor. A screen like this should pop up. Go up to File, Open. A window will pop up. And I am in the proper place right now, but I'm going to refresh the folder. And that looks correct. That's the file I'm trying to bring in and run. So I've now opened it in the editor by clicking the plus. And then this is all you have to do. Go to File, Save. Let me do that zoomed out on the next one. So I'm gonna go to File, Open. I'm gonna click the next one in the list. And then I'm going to go up here and click Save. Now watch, when I click this, you'll see a yellow wait pop up. And see, it was really quick. Let me do the next one. You have to do this for every program that you're bringing over to the Biesse, just the first time. It sets parameters on your tooling. I'm going to hit Save. Maybe you saw it that time. Now, what I found is, if there is something wrong with the code, and it's usually that a tool doesn't exist, or you're asking the machine to go to a coordinate outside of the parameter, or outside of the size of the machine, this wait will hang for like more than 3 seconds. Sometimes it'll be like 10 seconds or 15 seconds, that code's probably not going to work. That's just a red flag to to look for. All right, so now I go up to File, Exit, and then I go back up to Windows, Program, and this will pop up. I'm in Access Designs. I want to go to my job, and I refreshed, and I want to start with this program here, and I'll click that, and this is the holes program, so you can see that I have it loaded into the system. I'm going to now push the green start button. It asks me if my jig thickness is proper, which it is. Actually, it isn't. I have to change that. But I'm not going to run this program. But the next step after pushing the green button is to go down to your pedestal and pick the quadrant of the table that you are going to work with. So this is our number one quadrant. And we're going to push that. And the pins came up. There's a pin. There's a pin. And there's another pin. On our machine, we get 3-4 pins. And we don't have a pin on the end because it was having a trouble. But now you can push material onto the deck to those pins and line it up at the end of the machine. So you push it to the back edge, and then we line it up on this edge, just visually. And then we block out the table with, we have a 10-foot table, so we've got a 2-foot piece of MDF at the end, just blocking out the table for vacuum. All right, well, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was helpful. This process took me a bit of a challenge. When I first started working with Biesse, I've worked with CNC a lot, and I haven't run into a machine that works quite like Biesse. But that's okay. Maybe it's just I'm ignorant to how big machines work, so I don't know. But I hope that was helpful. Go ahead and like it, and I'm going to start a new channel so you can subscribe to that. It should be all based on this type of CNC work or CAD CAM or design. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Hope it was helpful. Hit the like button if you liked it, and be sure to comment if you have any issues. All right, thanks a lot.